गुड मॉर्निंग एंड जय हिंद. नाउ टुडे वी शैल हैव स्टडी अबाउट द कल्चरल डाइवर्सिटीज एंड द इंडियन नेशन स्टेट्स. अंडरस्टैंड इंडिया इज ऑल्सो आवर भारत इज ऑल्सो नेशन स्टेट्स. अंडरस्टैंड और कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड ऑफ द different communities or different language, or we know very well that India is also known as the museum of the different cultures. This is just at the museum, understand, in which the different kinds of cultures flourished in India, understand. Or now this, despite this different culture, it is said that India is also, it is called it is said that the unity in diversity, this is the a peculiar trend in India, understand. Or despite having our differences, differences or diversities, we now all have the feeling of the Indianity, whether the living in the from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, understand, and from Bharuch to the Tamralipti, understand. Now everyone, and from Ladakh, where the Ladakh to the Arunachal, these all those are living there, they feel that they are the Indians, they are the part of the Indians, understand. Or this feeling was not inculcated very easily. That feelings had been brought by a long struggle or inculcated. That feelings is based on our rich culture, understand, which makes presents a uniqueness to the world. And moreover, the political efforts made by our great leaders and our freedom fighters, they have tried to inculcate the sense of feelings of the nationality among them. So students, here we see that India is a country, vast India is a diverse country, or how the Indian nation states. We know that the process of the nation state building began from the French Revolution. After that, we see that after the French Revolution, then after the process of the making of the nation began, and we see that how the in the Germany, the nation states was built. Germany, before the becoming a nation state, divided in a petty state, dotted with the petty states, 360 states were there, understand. Or through these small petty states, now it was the Germany was got unified by the Bismarck, efforts of the Bismarck or the William or the Kaiser, understand, or William IV, they made the efforts, and under the leadership of the state, under the leadership of the state, understand, this was the made unified. Then after the Italian unification happened, understand, unification of Italy, the three persons were making a very important role, okay, the Victor Emmanuel, the king of the Piedmont Sardinia, understand, the Victor Emmanuel or the Count Cavour or the Mazarin, they now fabricated a nation state there. Their efforts now brought the sense of unity and the sense of collective identity amongst the Italians. Then we see that these unifications, the process of unification happened in Britain also, how the British Parliament now annexed the Wales, the English communities or English nations, how they brought the Ireland under their control, Scotland, then after on the Wales it was brought, or the United Kingdom was formed, the Greater United, and these all Scotland and Irish, they lost their own culture and assimilated into the British culture, into the British English culture. They assimilated. Yet the process of that and this trend of the unification of the nation states now went on in the different parts of the world. Understand? Or these fashions were also, these fashions were adopted in the Asian country, those had been for a very long time under the subjugation of these Europeans. And as the shackles and the fetters, they broke the fetters, understand? These countries emerged as a nation states, or emerged at the greater nation states, feeling of the nation states. And this feeling of the nation states had been brought by our nationalist, many factors. Was not only the nationalist leader, many factors were working behind this. I am not going to confine that only the nationalist or our leader, only they work out behind the formation or inculcation of the nation state. I can't say. Understand? Lots of the factors were behind this. Understand? Or even the British factors were behind this. Western factors were behind this. Western knowledge and factors were behind this. And only the leaders now work, and the work as a catalyst. As a catalyst arousing the people and awakening the people very fast or rapidly. Otherwise, this by later or sooner, this must have to be the come. Understand? Or despite having the British in India, this was to be the come. Understand? But this was the catalyzed or speeded up by our leaders. Understand? So now I am going to hear the cultural diversity or the Indian nation. Here, students, the Indian nation states, socially or culturally, one of the most diverse countries in the world. We know very well. We have language, thousands of language. We have the thousands of the hundreds of the dance, drama, architectural styles, food habits, costumes. Okay, different diverse. We have the socially or the culturally, India is a diverse country of the world. This is the, that's why the India is called as the museum, and it has population of about the 1,029 million people, more than that. This is the data, is the rather old data, but the 1,029 million people, currently the second largest, we know, I have not to make the statement, largest in the world, national population, and these now billion plus people speak about the 1,632 different languages. 1,632 languages is spoken, different spoken, and the dialects, or many as many 18 of these languages have been the officially recognized by the Indian Constitution. We know very well 18 had been the in the 8 schedules. Schedule of our Indian Constitution, this has been the included. We know very well. This is the, and the guarantee of their legal status has been the given. Or in terms of religion, what is the religious position in India? In terms, 80.5% according to your NCERT books, we are the 80.5% of population are the Hindus here. You know, India, Bharat is a Hindu dominant country, or the regionally specific, plural in the beliefs on the practices. Okay, different beliefs, different practices, and divided by the caste and the language. So the India is divided by the caste, by the creed, by the religion. About 13.4% population are the Muslims here. Okay, 30+4% पॉपुलेशन मुस्लिम है यहाँ पे भारत में, वी नो वेरी वेल, एंड विच मेक्स इंडिया द वर्ल्ड्स थर्ड लार्जेस्ट मुस्लिम कंट्री आफ्टर द इंडोनेशिया एंड पाकिस्तान, द थर्ड लार्जेस्ट कंट्री है जहाँ की मुस्लिम्स भारत में रहते हैं, द मुस्लिम्स एंड द अदर मेजर रिलीजियस कम्युनिटीज आर द लाइक द अदर कम्युनिटीज आर लिव द हियर, क्रिश्चियंस दे आर इन 2.3%, सिक्स ओनली 1.9%, बुद्धिस्ट 0.8%, जैन्स लेसर देन द 0.4%, जैन्स आर, सो द इंडिया हैज द ह्यूज पॉपुलेशन और दी ए स्मॉल परसेंटेज कैन ऑल्सो एड अप टू द लार्ज एब्सोल्यूट नंबर्स, तो वी कैन सी दैट दिस इज द पॉपुलेशन कंपोजिशन ऑफ भारत, पॉपुलेशन एंड द रिलीजियस कंपोजिशन ऑफ इंडिया, एंड इन टर्म्स ऑफ नेशन स्टेट रिलेशनशिप कम्युनिटी आइडेंटिटीज इंडिया नाउ केस फिट्स नाइदर एसिमिलेशन नॉट द इंटीग्रेशन मॉडल डिस्क्राइब, इंडिया neither adopt the assimilation theory or nor adopt the integration theory as the this has been the depicted or written in the box 6.2 mein aap dekhiyega, understand where we can see ki bharat na to assimilation policy apnata hai adopt karta hai or neither the india adopts the whether the integration policy. However, demand for such a model has been expressed by some section of the dominant Hindu community. Like some section of the Hindu community demands that if this kind of the policy should be the adopted, assimilation policy should be the adopted here. But although national integration is the constant theme in the state policy, or lekin भारत में जो नेशनल इंटीग्रेशन है ये कॉन्स्टेंट थीम इन द स्टेट पॉलिसी है, इंडिया हैज नॉट बीन इंटीग्रेशनिस्ट इन द वे ऑफ द बॉक्स 6.2 डिस्क्राइब्स, उस तरह से भारत इंटीग्रेशन पॉलिसी नहीं अपनाता, द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डिक्लेयर्स द स्टेट टू बी द सेकुलर स्टेट, आप जानते हैं कि इंडिया व्हेन द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वॉज बींग फ्रेम, तो हमारे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन जो बनाने वाले आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फ्रेमर्स आवर लीडर्स दे न्यू दैट कि इंडिया इन इंडिया देयर आर द डाइवर्स रिलीजियस पीपल्स लिव हियर, अंडरस्टैंड, एंड द माइनॉरिटीज लिव हियर, सो दैट्स व्हाई माइनॉरिटी मस्ट बी गिवन और स्पेयर्ड देयर रिलीजियस फ्रीडम, अंडरस्टैंड, सो दैट्स व्हाई इंडिया हैड बीन द डिक्लेयर्ड एट द सेकुलर स्टेट, व्हाई फॉर बिकॉज के अकॉर्डिंग टू द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन द डोमिनेंट क्लास वुड नॉट चेंज इट्स पॉलिसी एंड द undermine it means that a state would be the aloof, a state will stand and will keep distance from the all the religious group, understand, a state will keep the distance, a state will neither interfere, a state will neither encourage the any religion in India, understand, our constitutionally no government will come and go, but all government must have to be the follow the instruction of the constitution, the writings which has been the written in the constitution, they must have to be the follow this secular state, but religion, language and other such factors are not banished from the public spheres, understand, this had been the banished from public spheres, in fact communities have been the explicitly recognized by the state, or different communities have been the recognized by the state in our country, okay, and by international standards very strong constitutional protection offered to the minority religion in our country according to the national international standard, Bharat Indian constitution provides a protection, offers the protection to the all the minorities who are living in India, minorities, those who are the less in number and the population, their protection is now guaranteed by the Indian constitution, uske liye bharat ka jo samvidhan hai इंडियन जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन है वो गारंटी देता है. अंडरस्टैंड कि नाउ देयर कल्चर, देयर राइट्स, ओके, देयर आइडेंटिटी विल बी द प्रिजर्व और प्रिजर्व और प्रोटेक्टेड स्ट्रिक्टली बाय द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया. एंड द नो गवर्नमेंट हु कम्स इन द पावर वुड नाउ चेंज और वुड दे मस्ट हैव टू बी द गो थ्रू द guidelines of the Constitution of India, and they must have to be the give the protections to the minorities group in India. Understand? So now this has been the minority, or in general, India's problems have been the more in spheres of the implementation. Although the India gets the problem, although this has been the written down or the stipulated in the Indian Constitution, stipulate कर दिया गया है, लेकिन these are the stipulated. Or the practice rather than laws or the principles, okay? Rather than laws and principles, there are the problem problem on the ground. Iske implementations ke liye for that there are so many problems, but hurdles. But we have not to be the loss our hurts, okay? And we have to be the go ahead. But on the whole, India can be the considered a good example of the state nation. And on the whole, Bharat is a good state nation, though it is not entirely free from problems common to the nation state. Now there are so many problems to the common state. There are so many suspicion of the states that the any part or any community would be the separated, would be the detached from that. They can demand for the isolated states or the separate states. They could have the demand. Understand? But even then, there are so many. These are the great danger and the khatra for the our Indian constitution, our nation states. But even then, there are so many remedy has been the done or the remedy has been the given in the Indian Constitution to meet such kind of the circumstances. Understand? Such kind of the, even though our Indian Constitution was being framed, this is the reason that our more power has been given to the center at the in our confederation. In our federal structure, adhik power kisko diya gaya? Central government has been given the much power by the padhe hain ki first list, the union list, concurrent list or state list. So in that, the union list have the more subject, concurrent list has the some subjects, and the state list on the only the state have the exclusive right to form the law and legislate. लेजिस्लेशन तो दैट इज द स्टेट. बट यहाँ हम देखेंगे कि वन सिटीजनशिप कोई भी फेडरल स्ट्रक्चर होता है तो वहां पे डबल सिटीजनशिप दिया जाता है. जैसे अमेरिका है, अमेरिका हैविंग द डबल सिटीजनशिप, बट इन आवर कंट्री देयर इज अ सिंगल सिटीजनशिप. वहां पे इन अमेरिका द सिटीजन इज बिलोंग्स टू द कैलिफोर्निया, तो ही इज द सिटीजन ऑफ कैलिफोर्निया एंड एज वेल एज सिटीजन ऑफ द अमेरिका. अंडरस्टैंड? और हमारे यहाँ आप यू नो वेरी वेल कि जो कॉन्फेडरेशन है, एंड द यूनियन है या फेडरेशन है, तो दिस इज द फेडरल स्ट्रक्चर है, तो दैट इज द होल्डिंग टुगेदर. दैट इज द इन अमेरिका देयर इज अ कमिंग टुगेदर, दे हैव पुल देयर सॉवरेंटी टुगेदर. अंडरस्टैंड? इन अमेरिका एंड इन आवर कंट्री द होल्डिंग टुगेदर, एंड दैट इज वाई द डिफरेंट all states have not been the given the equal power, not been allotted the equal power and the equal status in our country. Understand? So the power and the varies state to state allocation of the resources varies state to state in our country. Understand? Or the center state on the this is the not a, according to the federal structure or the center states having the various the powers and not a states a state does not stand equal to the center. Understand? This is the reason of that. let's see regionalism in the Indian context. Regionalism, what is the regionalism in general sense? What it is the regionalism means, now the if the issues are concerned, the leaders of the state, the local people having their own issues, understand, and they are not concerned with the national issues and the international issue, they are exclusively concerned with the local issues, understand, or they make their own identity, they try to make their form their own identity or own autonomous state and own rights and autonomous state. This kind of the tendency called as the regionalism. And emphasis is given not on the national issues, emphasis is given on the local issues. So this tendency is can be called as the regional tendency or the regionalism. So here we or the regional identity is formed there. Understand, regional identity, regional issues are dominant in the sense of the regionalism. So now, students, regionalism in India is rooted in India diversity in language. And this regionalism is why? This regionalism is why? Because of the diverse language. On the basis of the language, the regional identity is formed. On the basis of the language where that is spoken, on the basis of the culture, tribes, religion, on that basis the regionalism feelings is the created, or the regionalism is the expressed, or it also encourages geographical concentration of these identity markers in a particular region. कहीं some states में geographical कॉन्टेक्स्ट में या जियोग्राफिकल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन अगर के फॉर्म में रीजनलिज्म एक्सप्रेस किया जाता है, और फ्यूल्ड बाय द सेंस ऑफ रीजनल डिप्राइवेशन, और इसके साथ साथ फ्यूल्ड रीजनल डिप्राइवेशन से भी, अगर मान लीजिए फॉर एग्जाम्पल द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट पेइंग और एलोकेटिंग द सर्टेन स्टेट्स द रिसोर्सेज, तो दैट व्हाट हैपेंस बिकॉज ऑफ दैट the sense of deprivation now is created there, and that comes under the minds of the people living in a certain geographical area, understand, that this also creates the sense of regionalism here. And Indian federalism, Bharat ne Indian federalism has been means the accommodating these regional sentiments. So India always try to accommodate to these all regional sentiments by this. Or we know that our country got the independence. Initially, Indian states continued with British Indian arrangements. Now, as our country got freedom, understand? So the British had what they had did. The Britishers had the Indian Independence Act was passed in the British Parliament, okay, and in that resolution it was said that India or India more than the 500 native states were in India, and they were subordinate of the British Crown. And now British Crown, on the British government, on the side of the British government, for Indian Independence Act, it was said that these 500 princely states, whether they could assimilate or they could be integrated themselves willingly by their willingness to the Indian Union, or they had the right to form their own independent states with their own constitution. So the British government own constitution, understand, or they could whether stay in India with the Indian Union government, or they could now assimilate it, they could go
with the Pakistan also. Understand? So now here a great problem after the independence arose, and moreover, the more problem was that how to reconstitute the Indian provinces and Indian states, on which ground, on which methods, and on the which, by which principles the Indian states should be the constituted. New Indian state formation should be the done. On the which principles? This was also a big question before the people living in our, the leaders who are the making the Indian constitution. And moreover, these questions were left unsolved, and the unsolved. The after the independence, the British arrangement, they left India, and they had made the arrangement. So according to their arrangement, the Indian arrangement divided India into the large provinces, also called the presidency. We know very well the British ruled our country, dividing the into the three presidency. The three presidency. The first, the Madras presidency, Kolkata presidency, and the Bombay presidency. So they divided the Indian presidency in the three part: Bombay, Calcutta, three major presidency, or incidentally all three cities after which the presidency were named have changed their names recently. Okay, these were the large multi-ethnic or multilingual provinces, states. These states were the multilingual or the multi-ethnic group were living in these states, constituting a major political administrative units, semi-federal state called the Union of India. Understand? They were living with the multi-language, living with the multi-ethnic groups, and come under the Union of the India. Okay? Or as an example, I am telling you, Old Bombay, take the state, Old Bombay state. Understand? Wadi. Multilingual state of the multilingual state, Old Bombay, which was the left after the independence, multilingual like the Marathi, Gujarati, Kannada, Kokani speaking people, and on that basis the peoples were demanding for their separate states. On the basis of the language they were demanding that. They were not ready for living together the Bombay, Old Bombay. And similarly, Madras state, agar dekha jai, the constituted by Madras state also. It was constituted by the major four language, the Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam. These language were in the Madras presidency, or in addition, the presidencies of provinces directly administered by the British Indian government. And now, these were the directly administered. There were also a large number of princely states, principalities all over the India. I have already mentioned that more than the 500 larger, like the Hyderabad, Jammu and Kashmir, or Junagadh, understand, Baroda, these were the larger and the big states ruled by their own kings and the rulers and Nawab. Understand? But this was a big problem before the constitution, before our leaders. How to resolve this problem? Or now, here, also the princely state principalities, larger princely states include the Mysore, Kashmir, Baroda, and but soon after adoption of constitution, all these units of the colonial era had to be the reorganized into the ethno-linguistic, and these all area and the regions after the independence has to be the reorganized. Isko fir se reorganize karna tha states ko. Kis ground par, kis adhar par? On the basis of ethno-linguistic state par. Bhasha ke adhar par aur ethnicities ke adhar par. ग्राउंड पे, अंडरस्टैंड। इसको फिर से रिओर्गेनाइज करना था। मेन इंडियन यूनियन इन रेस्पॉन्स टू स्ट्रॉन्ग पॉपुलर एजिटेशन, और इसके बाद एक स्ट्रॉन्ग पॉपुलर एजिटेशन से ऑल ओवर द इंडिया चला, अंडरस्टैंड, स्टार्ट हुआ। क्योंकि लीडर्स जो भी आए थे इंडिपेंडेंस में के लिए, फ्रीडम फाइटर्स में या इलेक्शन में जो भी हुआ, जो फर्स्ट इलेक्शन, तो उन्होंने प्रॉमिस करके आया था, दे हैड प्रॉमिस्ड देयर पीपल, देयर रीजनल पीपल की तहत कि दे वुड पुट द डिमांड बिफोर द इन द पार्लियामेंट फॉर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द न्यू स्टेट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द लैंग्वेज, बेसिकली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ लैंग्वेज। समवेयर दे डिमांडेड their states to be the constituted on the basis of the ethnicity, on the basis of the culture, ethnicity, ethnic identity, tribal identity. These all were demanding, they had promised, these leaders who had been elected in the first election of the parliament, understand, they had now promised, and they were to have to put the demand before the Nehru. But it became the big question before the Nehru, and the others were very afraid of that. If the such kind of state will be the created, understand, on the basis of the language, on the basis of the ethnicity, like that, this would certainly, this would weaken our union. But this not happened so. Understand, state reorganization commission was set up. Or on that basis, on the report of that, the states were constituted on the basis of the basis of a languages. But this now strengthened our unity, our union, our union or our federation. Isne federation ko kya kiya? What did they now made the more stronger? Wo aaj hamara wahi resulted in the more stronger federation. Despite that, कहाँ division हुआ? This now they express the more unity to the Indians. Understand? Despite having their own states on the basis of the language. Understand? So now students, we have to be the here the language coupled with a regional or tribal identity. Understand? A tribal identity and not on the religion has therefore provided the most powerful instrument for the formation of ethno-national identity of India. Not the religion was not set apart, but the language was made there. The instrument, language or ethnic identity became the more pressing. However, this does not mean that all linguistic community have got the statehood, or aisa nahi tha ki sabhi linguistic group ko statehood ka they got the statehood position, सबको नहीं मिला, लेकिन in the creation of the new जैसे states 2000 में आप जानते हैं, you know very well that जैसे छत्तीसगढ़ है, उत्तराखंड है और झारखंड है, you know very well that based on the tribal identity, language, regional deprivation or ecology provided the basis of the intense regional resulting in the statehood, regionalism वहाँ हुआ on the basis of ethnicity or tribalism ke aadhar par, to statehood mana gaya aur provided the basis for their statehood. Currently after the hanaki isme 28 there is in your book there, but states are the more, and the federal units 7 union that has been also changed. You should books mein to aisa hai, understand, so you have to be the keep in the mind your books, because the jo framer hai, jo moderators hote hain, तो वो बुक से ही पढ़ा बना, अगर रिवाइज्ड बुक नहीं है तो इसी फैक्ट्स को मानेंगे, अंडरस्टैंड, क्योंकि एनसीईआरटी गोज थ्रू द जो मॉडरेटर्स हैं वो बुक से ही बनाते हैं। ओके, एंड यूनियन टेरिटोरीज सेंट्रल एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर सेंट्रली एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर एडमिनिस्टर्ड विदाउट द इंडियन नेशन होम। ओके, नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर द वर्ड स्टेट हैज बीन वी हैव स्टडीड इन दिस चैप्टर very easily, that you have in the political science aapne padha hoga, political science mein bhi this is the subject of political science also. Now you have studied in political science also the
here we are respecting regional sentiments, just a matter of the creating the state. Okay, so regional sentiments became the matter of the just a matter of the creating the state. I suppose time is over. Okay, the next period mein I shall discuss the more. और नेक्स्ट पीरियड में थोड़ा सा एक लिटिल पार्ट है इन दिस टॉपिक में है उसको हम आई विल एक्सप्लेन और देन आफ्टर आई शैल एक्सप्लेन इन द नेशनल स्टेट्स एंड द रिलीजन रिलेटेड टू इस आइडेंटिटी है ना. दैट्स व्हाई थैंक यू वेरी मच. इट इज़